Who is the only athlete in the history of the Olympic Games to get a personal mention in the closing ceremony?
Achilles?
No, we're talking about the modern Olympiads.
Paula Radcliffe.
Olympus.
Eddie the Eagle.
Not Paul Radcliffe.
Jesse
Sorry?
Owens.
Eddie the Eagle.
Eddie the Eagle is the right answer. What year was it?
92? 88?
88 is right. 88 is absolutely right. And what was his discipline?
Ski jumper.
He embodied the spirit.
He kind of just fell off the end of it. Yeah.
Didn't he embody the
there
spirit?
There he is.
Yes, there was nothing wrong with it. Look at this. Could you do this?
I couldn't do that.
And they all laughed at him. Look, why?
Well, you didn't laugh at Little Titch, you did much the same.
No, because...
Yeah, if he could put his own hat on, that would be different.
Juan Antonio Samaranch, the leader of the IOC, he said, at this Olympic Games, some competitors... He probably said, but I'm going to go on any further. Have won gold and some have broken records, and one has even flown like an eagle.
Flown like an eagle.
Like an eagle. But sadly, they then legislated so that people like Eddie would not be able to participate anymore. They said that in order to participate in the Olympics, you had to be in the top 30% in your international competition, or one of the top 50 of the world, whichever. And so it closed the gate on inspired amateurs like Eddie, which is surely against the spirit of the Olympics. I mean, bless him, he had to wear glasses which frosted up. He was in a country which has no ski jumps, in England. He was just practising without having any ski jumps to practise on.
Just coming off the roof of his house.
Well, basically, I think he probably was. Why was he picked for the team, though?
Because there wasn't anyone else.
Yeah, because he was the only one who volunteered, which I think is absolutely wonderful.
I'll have a go.
Now, who else was there who was a doubly... Not just Eddie the Eagle, there was another one a few years later. Do you remember?
Oh, there was a swimmer.
Eric the Eel. Eric the Eel from Equatorial Guinea.
People had to hang around. They were putting the lights out.
Well, bless him. When he arrived, I'm not wishing to sound patronising, but I just said bless him, so there's no way out. He said he only learnt to swim 8 months before the Olympic Games. And he'd never seen an Olympic pool before he stood on the edge of one.
Got to see it and went, bloody hell. Miles!
Exactly. Oh, well, there you are. It's right. It's Eddie the Eagle, who, despite his acknowledged entertainment value, resulted in a rule called the Eddie the Eagle rule that excluded colourful amateurs from the Olympics. Hard to imagine anything less in keeping with the original ethos of the game.